What's up, people? This your boy Seven for Adam back to you with another video. And on this video, man, we're gonna take it back in history for a minute. We're gonna talk about the cross movement, tunnel rat situation. A lot of people don't know about what happened back then. A lot of the, you know, the newer CHH fans or what so. So, I got a brother that love cross movement, but he don't, you know, really know about the situation they had with the tunnel rats. And then, I told Lucky Murray on his, video he did about, Ruslan the CHH that, you know, I try to cover that, cross movement, tunnel rat situation. And a lot of this stuff is, I mean, it's already, you know, you can Google some of this stuff. Well, pretty much everything you probably can Google yourself for what was actually going on, you know, behind the scenes or whatever. But, now this is just me going off, just as a fan, remembering. And we can go back and start from the beginning. You know, tunnel rats came in the game first. They came in when it wasn't even CHH then, it was just, you know, gospel rap. But you had, like, that's around the time when the Soldiers for Christ were pretty doing their thing. And everybody that was around them, you know, the Dynamic Twins, Idol Kings, Freedom of Soul, you know. That whole little, you know, clique, man, they were pretty much, you know, on the scene doing their thing. And, Soldier for Christ had dropped the Phase 3 album, and which was an amazing album. And it kind of took, you know, the gospel route into a different direction, because it was they was trying to get out of the 80s type flow. And you know, when the 90s came in, the flows kind of switched. So, gospel rap was evolving. And Phase 3 was one of the first albums that kind of were going into that different phase, the 90s era. And they introduced Alliance of Light, you know, which everybody knew as it came out as the Gospel Gangsters. And that was like the first album that kind of transitioned, you know, going into the new directions or whatever. But you got to remember, even back then, there was no crews or nobody that had a lot of theologicals in their rhymes. They were really spit. Even just the name Jesus, you didn't really hear that a lot back then. Like, you heard it a little, but not as much. And so then you come back, was it like 94? Soldiers for Christ came back with another album. And but this time it will mostly suit the Chemist, but you notice he had some new guys on the album. And that the Illumination album came and it sounded different than the Phase 3 album. And you heard these guys rapping on there, and even Suit the Chemist style kinda had changed. And like I say, that when the phase was changing, we're going into a different direction. But on the album, you heard these guys that was spinning so hard. And come to find out, it was LPG from the Tunnel Rats. Now, the Tunnel Rats still weren't known yet. They haven't even came out, made themselves known or whatever like that. And that's the first time you hear them on there. So then, like, I think 95, you got LPG dropped their first album. And it was, Earthworm, yo. So they come on the scene. And West Coast guys, you know, another West Coast group, because pretty much a lot of gospel rap was coming out of, you know, the West Coast, with Soldiers for Christ and all of them. So then you got LPG coming on the scene, and you know, these are like these battle rappers. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't never no crews or nobody that was coming through gospel rap that was battle rappers. So these guys come in, you know, something totally different. Something that you never really never heard. You could even hear it with the way they spit that they was, it was something different about them. You know what I'm saying? And kind of find out they were battle rappers. So the Earthworm album take off. Great album, you know what I'm saying? They couldn't go to a lot of churches because of, you know, rap would still be looking at it as something evil and, you know, stuff like that. So churches wouldn't invite them out, you know, and they had songs that they'll go to, that they'll perform, and, you know, just the struggle back then to just try to perform at churches and stuff. And then it really wasn't until 1996 that we got introduced to the Tunnel Rats, where they dropped their first album called Experience. And then they released, I think Future Shock dropped their first album. And Peace586 dropped his album, the Risen Sun. And you know, Peace587 come from Freedom of Soul. So he was coming from that old crews with Soldiers for Christ and all that. And he coming to this new crew with the Tunnel Rats, and the styles change, you know what I'm saying? And it's like the battle rap type flows and the beats and all that. So Tunnel Rats on the scene, they making noises. 96 was a whole year, it was just Tunnel Rats, you know what I'm saying? Making all the noise. So here comes 1997, 98 comes in, and we got this crew called the Cross Movement. And they come in with Heaven's Mentality. And this is why Cross Movement made such a big impact. It because when they came in the game, they came at, and Fnatic had touched on this, but you can even tell back then when you heard the album, they came in attacking everyone that was kind of bashing Jesus. Because back then, it seemed like that was the thing, like, let's make fun of, you know, Jesus, or let's bash Jesus, or, you know, all that type of stuff. You know, like, he pointed out about the Nas with the, he went to hell for snuffing Jesus, and then Ambassador brought up the fact that his original album cover for Illmatic was going to be, he was going to have Jesus in a headlock, and, you know, all that type of stuff, man. And I remember that being popular back then, when people were just dogging Jesus or whatever. So when they came out with Heaven's Mentality, it was the first time you really heard an album that had a lot of, like, boasting about Jesus on every song. You know, Lowercase God's Bow Down to the Capitol. With El Elyon, Who's the Man? They even talked about when they performed Who's the Man in New York out in public, and people were, like, hanging out the windows and looking. You know, and all that, if you know back then in New York, and I'm quite sure still today, they community was heavily influenced by the 5%ers. Cross Movement went out there performing Who's the Man, proclaiming Jesus is Lord and King of Kings. So you really never seen nothing like that before. That was something new. You know what I'm saying? So that's why they impact was so big, and they made a lot of noise. You know what I'm saying? So moving forward, you know, Cross Movement started elevating, getting a lot of attention, you know what I'm saying? And they was one of the first ones that would start getting accepted by churches, start going and performing at all the churches. And I think the next thing they dropped was Christology and Layman Turn kind of just put the stamp on it, you know what I'm saying? Like they own it, you know what I'm saying? They going to all the churches, and then Christology and Layman Turn had a big, like, part of was it an album release party? Like, I mean, it's on YouTube. Like, Corey Ritter Precise with performing their songs off Market of East. Like, it was just a big thing, man. Everybody from Philly was talking about they was there. Probably one of the biggest album release parties in Christian hip hop history, because that's the one that I hear them talk about, that it seemed like everybody was there. And so then, you know, you got that. I'm trying to think. I don't think Tunnel Rats released nothing after 96 until it might have been the Tunnel Rats album, The Tunnel Vision. But even before they released that, what happened was Of course, you know, Crawl Movement came back with House of Representatives. Now, they were just dropping. The Tunnies. The Tunnies did an interview where he was talking about how the Tunner Rats, like, they glorify their rhymes too much. And, you know, it's not enough boasting about Christ or whatever like that. And that interview when Tunnies did that, to me, that kind of started it something that's actually still going on today, because you got both sides kind of, you got, like, today you got the reform cat saying it ain't enough Jesus in the music and it ain't this and it ain't that, need to get back to that. Then you got the other side saying, man, that's the old style, that's corny, you ain't got to do all this Jesus stuff, and don't you know the book of Esther didn't say the word Jesus? I'm so tired of hearing that. Like, that, y'all can stop saying that. If you a believer, you read the Bible, everybody know that Esther do not mention God's name once. So I'm tired of hearing that. So you got that side saying that, and then you got this side saying we need to get back to that. I'm tired of that too. Like, I think it need to be equal. Like, it's good for both sides. Because even during that time, I was listening to both. I was on Tunner Rats and I was on Crawl Movement. But that kind of where the distraction came from when Tunnies made that statement. And I don't know what went on. I hope nothing didn't go on behind the scenes or whatever. But my initiative, like, what I think it was, the Tunner Rats, I don't think they ever did a response. But I do remember on one of them blogs, I can't remember what the blog was. It might have been, it was something gospel. I don't know if it was the Gospel Coalition or something. And one of the crews in the Tunnel Rats said something. I can't remember which one it was. I can't remember which group. One of the groups in the Tunnel Rats. You know, Tunnel Rats had groups inside of the crew. You know, you had LPG. God, I can't remember the name of all the groups. But one of the groups had made a comment. I think one of the magazines or blogs asked them about it. And they kind of broke it down where they were saying that Crawl Movement is more like Jesus when he walked on them. No? Paul. That's how they said it.
Crawl Movement. Pockets filled with lint, not one red cent for the misfit transient and severed existence and resemblance to the only absolute known as Christ. I bear my cross in hopes to lead a broken life. Like doing exhibitions with the electric commissions for the future tense past due. Payment is driven down a street that's narrow, one way with the light at the corner, odd way, while the cross street is Broadway. Travel by the mini for the penny, but coins can't procure a way out of the dead end road. See that signal? What? It's red for stop and ponder the lamb's bloodshed engraved inside the head. Thus, my desire is to light a fire in the night, to be chosen as a shining token of the broken light.
Come on. Now, as a tide's turn, we carry a cross, toss in the...
All right, let's continue on. I got interrupted. But, yeah, one of the groups out of the Crawl Movement, not the Crawl Movement, but the Tunnel Rats, they were talking about, they were comparing them. Like, they were saying Crawl Movement is more like Paul. How Paul was, you know, boasting about Christ and teaching about Christ and, you know, stuff like that. And they say the Tunnel Rats were more like Jesus. And they were talking about the ministries, meaning Crawl Movement was kind of intertwined with Paul's ministry, and the Tunnel Rats was in more twined with Jesus' ministry. Meaning they were actually trying to, the same type of ministry Jesus was doing, they were saying that they was basically doing the same thing. Like, they was going out, you know, like they described their battles, like when they were battling with people, as the same way, like when the Pharisees would come and ask Jesus questions and he'll, you know, tell them this and tell them that. So that was kind of the comparison they did, but it went no disrespect. I remember reading it like, dang, they ain't even, you know, disrespect them or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? So then they came back, like right after that, they came out with the Tunnel Vision album. And I remember the first single they had dropped, they had the video for it and everything. And they came out, like, the first line was like, you know, I caught the gun back, blah, 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 and whatever like that. And people were like, you know, dang, like, even after, you know, the Tunnets had made that statement, you know, or, you know, representing the Quad Movement, they still came back, like, yeah, battle rap style, you know what I'm saying? Coming by it, busting, or whatever. And people think that that was kind of a response to what Tunnets had said, but I don't really think it was, you know, but I do believe that last song on there, that LPG did, I do believe that's the response to Cross Movement. I don't think I heard anybody say that. I ain't never heard nobody say it or anything like that, but I can guarantee you that last song on Tunnel Vision that LPG did, I believe they talking about Crawl Movement. That's my belief. I don't think they ever said it was or nothing like that. And I might play a little snippet of it in the video or whatever, but...
For years I sat and watched and often had the urge to speak on all these mediocre gospel rappers skidding off the beat. Perpetrating my how they tight, now open mics get freaked. Knowing full well you weak and couldn't reach me at your peak. And what's worse is your excuse. Christian MC shouldn't burn. But the fact is you ain't got no talent till you pass when it's your turn. Saying it's not the will of God and TRs be off the mark. But you kill the art and Christian kids are still in dark about it. Taking every word you say and story told is precious gold. Cause God ain't in your songs, that's the reason you ain't sold a lot. I got news for your crew, you can't pay your dues in credit. Cause you grew up in a church, don't qualify you for the mic session, I said it. And I cannot if you don't understand my calling. I still keep walking like I'm balling and you all be tripping, falling. Thinking you tight cause you work with evangelists worldwide. Cause when they ask you to sound like Snoop, you just could not deny it. It's like this, God has made me exactly who I am. And I'd be damned if I had killed it to fulfill the will of man. See, it's hard to understand it, so you question my success. Cause I drive a bucket to the show and go to mama's house to rest. I probably never had what you got, but that's not why I've endured. But so cats like you won't have to sleep on the floor when they on tour. And I know my place, and I'll be in it till I'm done. But the last shall be first, and I've been last since day one. Remember that?
I think after that, you know, when really nothing else, like, I think Quad Movement came back with the Holy Culture album, and that just took off, took it to a whole nother level, and they didn't really make no statement or nothing like that on the album, you know, as far as to turn of rap, but it was never no beef or nothing like that. It was just Tunnets made that statement, and then, you know, the Tunnel Rats made their statement, you know, and that was it. It wasn't no disrespect, none of that, you know what I'm saying? And then I think, like, years later, I remember Propaganda did an interview where he was, like, he performed with the Fanatic. And it was, like, the first time that somebody from the Tunnel Rats and Cross Movement was on the stage together. And, you know, he was, like, you know, they talked, and I think he said he thanked Fanatic. Because Fanatic gave him some type of advice about making grown folk music or something like that. So that was very interesting, man. But the Crawl Movement and Tunnel Rat thing still come up because of what's still going on. Like I said earlier, like, you got both sides. This side saying, you got the Crawl Movement side, like what they were saying. And then you got people like the Tunnel Rat side. They kind of saying about the same thing the Tunnel Rat was saying. But I always say, I think both sides are needed. They need to all just come together. Because imagine the Tunnel Rat would have did a song with the Quad Movement. Like, that would have been big. It would have been huge. So, that's my remembrance on it, man. Two of the biggest crews that ever come through Christian hip hop, man. And, you know, with Quad Movement and Tunnel Rat, I think both of them like this, they together. I'll never put one over the other, man. Unless you talking about the best group, because I think Crawl Movement was, I looked at them as a group, but the Tunnel Rats, I looked at them like a crew. I think the Tunnel Rats is the best crew that ever come through Christian hip hop, but Crawl Movement is the best group that ever come through Christian hip hop. But that my take on it, man. That's what I remember about it. If anybody else, you know, remember anything about that situation, you know, if you remember, coming in the comment section. Let me know what I missed out or anything like that, man. And if you like the story, man, you know, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. Hope I can do more stuff like that, man, because I've been with Christian Hip Hop for a while, man. I know my history, you know what I'm saying? So, man, this is Simon from Adam, man. saying peace to all y'all, man. And I'm gonna keep these videos coming, man. Deuces.